Launch, as you know, in the summer and into May. We've been talking to news readers, we've talked to a couple already, we're talking to a lot more this week, so that's about where we are. So it's tight, but should still be possible.
The gallery isn't ready till the 5th of June, so they can't look at the new mixer until then anyway. It's more a matter of running order training, which we can do in tandem with the PJs.
Okay.
Another one, Bill. Remember we talked about putting up a teletext page 100?
Yeah.
Cost-wise, it can be done for less than 10,000. But if we want to do it, we need to get on with it.
It's going very well, but just as I say, it's a lot of work. We are now at the stage of thinking about actually having a timetable up to launch. The next big thing really is to sort out the training, because there is so much training in three different areas for three different bunches of people, many of whom have never been in the doors of ITN in their lives, you know nothing about the system here, nothing about the technical operation here. They all need to be trained, so that's the next big project. Running parallel with that, obviously there are other things. The studio is currently being built, there's very good progress being made there. We're looking at innovative ways of doing the weather and the travel news. So there's lots of operations going on amongst lots of different sectors of the ITN staff to make this thing work and to get it on the air in time.
This is Bill Bayliss and Dave Hewson. Six is a sting.
Very good. It's fine as a piece of music. My worry would be that it would overemphasise the potential joyrider aspects of the sequence. You know, it's a sort of exciting, whizzy journey. So,
yeah, I think this is all a bit whizzy, as you say, and I think the tempo will pull back a bit.
What we've done up to now is that we've actually always tailored our product to suit the clients. This is ITN in its raw form. This is core ITN. And so what we're having to do is really sort of reinvent ourselves and say this is us. And what it is news direct from ITN to the public, when and where you want it. So it's not really all just about the television channel. It's about ITN being available across all platforms.
Well, just as we are with the television channel, we're launching a digital radio channel in the summer. And the two are going to work in parallel, and we're working together at the moment to come up with similar solutions and similar ideas, and they're going to work off a very similar wheel. But this is a rolling news, a national rolling news digital radio channel, which will bear the ITN brand. At the moment, as many people will know, we operate two radio stations down here in the basement in the newsroom. You can see happening behind me, LBC and News Direct, but this one will have the ITN brand very much on it. It's going to be a national channel. It'll be on the first digital multiplex, so it'll be alongside Classic FM and Virgin and stations called One Word, which is a plays, books and comedy station, Core, Planet Rock, other music stations as well, and it will be our own rolling news channel, and it's going to come out of this newsroom.
The latest thinking was that this is on another machine, so that is actually like on the low frame super machine. The problem there is going to be a join, isn't it?
Yeah.
Our main task really is actually the on-air look for the channel, but it's very important initially in terms of working with Lambie Nairn that the whole branding process is working across all of the media. That's the most important thing in terms of the service on the phones, telephones, the WAP phones, the online news service and the channel itself.
We're in NTL Digital Media Centre. We currently have 135 channels coming through us. Room for more. This is where ITN 24-hour news will also be coming through when it's up and running.
For ITN, I think it's a phenomenal opportunity for you to extend what is a terrific brand, a brand that is well recognized in the customer's mindset, not only in the UK but worldwide, and it's an opportunity for you to expand that brand and to extend what you're very good at in the past to embracing kind of the future. And what I say again is the broadband future, embracing not only the potential for interactivity, for applications across more than just television, because as we all know, the potential for extending news and content to, you know, wireless telephones, for example, or PDAs, you know, personal assistants. Things like that are the future. And I think that ITN has recognized that the future is going to be different than obviously the past. And so they want to embrace that, and that this is the opportunity to do it.
Time to know. Well, it's just like you're going deeper into the void. It's running to 7. The logo's coming on around 5.
I think that's right for an urgent quarter-hour update on the news headlines. I don't think it's too overplayed.
When we sat down to discuss what the ITN news channel would be, the essential word was directness. We were looking for an image which wasn't a tired old news cliche. So we developed the idea of the arrow as something that was suitably neutral, abstract, but could also be dynamic. It could be functional, it could point to information, it could lead you to stories. And it represents that direct connection between ITN, the provider of news with integrity, to the consumer, the viewer, the radio listener, or whoever wants news and information online, on screen, wherever.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
on the roll.
Troops ready to evacuate Britons from Sierra Leone. Parents anger at hospital experiment on their children. And inside Britain's newest world-class art gallery. This is the ITN News Channel. It's 9 o'clock and I'm Shuli Ghosh. Hundreds of Britain's elite troops are tonight in the volatile and violent capital of Sierra Leone as the evacuation of Britons gets underway. The soldiers from the 1st Battalion of the Parachute Regiment have already secured the main airport there. More troops are on the way. The 550 Britons living in and around the capital Freetown have been told to get ready to leave.
With just a few hours' notice, paras were preparing to leave Bryce Norton on their way to one of the most dangerous countries in Africa.
We need to be different. We, as you know, have a tie-up with NTL, so it's all about interactivity, it's all about all the latest technology. And we also want to provide a basic service that's different. We want to get away from long-form back half hours filled with lighter programmes or current affairs imported from other departments, etc., etc. This will be a rolling news channel where in 15 minutes you'll get your news hit no matter when you watch.
You're going to make it?
We'll make it.
Five. 4, 3, 2, 1.
This is the ITN News Channel.
Explosion in Ulster, 2 injured in Belfast. England arrive home from Euro 2000 defeat. And the government holds a summit on skinny models. Father and son have been injured in an explosion in a nationalist area of West Belfast. The cause is still unknown, but security forces are now examining a garden shed behind a terraced house where the explosion is understood to have taken place.
Good evening. Remarkable new pictures of Prince William have just been released. It's a unique and informal record of the Prince at Eton. Police in Holland say they've arrested one person in Rotterdam over the deaths of the 58 people found crammed into an airtight lorry in Dover.
England today face their biggest test of the Euro 2000 football tournament as a huge security operation swings into action in Belgium.
Now on LWT London Tonight with Anna Maria Ash and Alasdair Stewart.
Tonight, the Jill Dando murder suspect, detectives hunting the TV presenter's killer, get more time to question the man held for the past 2 days.
He's just been a fantastic news editor. He's given 100% the whole time. Sometimes I think to the detriment of his home life, or he has been heard to say in the past that his two favourite things in his life are his girlfriends and football, and that news editing basically ruins both of them.
I feel like the dunce in the corner standing on the chair.
The president, I'll do that in a minute.
Give me the president in a minute. I'm speechless, I'm afraid. I haven't prepared anything. Sorry for inflicting the camera crew on you.
It was time to try something different and grapple with a new challenge, which the news channel certainly will be. And for me personally, to be kind of step into the dark, because you kind of think, you know, am I up to this job? Will I be able to do it? You think, am I going to be able to cope with a different news agenda? So there's some trepidation there, but I think I was kind of relishing the challenge, really. I mean, I personally think I can handle it, and hopefully I'll prove that I can.
Starting to arrive, the equipment's being put into place, the studio's being built. We're working closely with our partners NTL on the launch. We've got distribution sorted out very widely. We've got distribution on Astra. We're negotiating with Telewest for distribution. We've got a window on digital terrestrial television, and we've got distribution right across the NTL system, both on analog and on digital. We will, from day one, be available to something of the order of 12 million viewers.
What you will be doing, in a sense, is creating a channel which will be, in a very real sense, the heart of ITN. And so it's really important that although you're new and the programme you're creating is going to be new, that it remains ITN through and through. And if you cut it through like a stick of rock, you'll find the letters ITN in it.
It's not a coincidence that the desks for the news channel have been put in the ITV newsroom. We went down the road very early on of not having a separate area for the news channel, but to put it right next to the ITV operation. And the sort of double message that we've been given to people is that we must maintain the quality of programming on the ITV news programmes. There's no doubt about that. We will continue to do that. But at the same time, we're determined as a management team to give our full weight and full support to making sure that the news channel is as successful as possible.
And then you can just, as I say, when you call it up, you just go to view my column, view my layout, and it gives you the exact layout as you want it.
Obviously, there's a kind of shift in the culture of the news operation here. It's been geared to programmes that happen at lunchtime or in the early evening or at later in the evening as well. That has to change, but we're in at the birth of that kind of change, and that's the difficulty we're kind of wrestling with at the moment. And obviously, everyone's wrestling with it, and people are keen to change it, but we're just seeing how the systems are going to be changed to make that work.
The key thing for weather graphics is obviously people understand and take it in very clearly, because they're going to be dipping in and out of the 24-hour channel. So something that's going to work as little snapshots really of the weather. At this stage, we've decided on the actual look for the colours and the icons. At this stage, I'm actually producing the animations to make, you know, the raindrops work, the snow falling down correctly. So just working on the technical animation.
One of the main things I'm working on at the moment is the graphics for the travel information that will be appearing on the channel. They are generated by a computer system which has got the very latest information about the traffic jams on the roads. So this service is coming direct from our travel suppliers. It's not something that's held up in between by translation from information to graphics to the viewer.
Every day you have a chance to be involved in the launch of a new channel. The challenge is to get my head around the proposition of being involved at a senior level with a rolling news channel, with all that demands. Apart from anything else, the logistics are quite mind-boggling.
Have you heard of a new news channel, ITN, that's set to launch at the end of July? Predominantly it's targeting the adult ABC market, which I know you're targeting for MasterCard.
The difference with ITN is that because it's cutting-edge news, because it's contemporary, advertisers are rightfully going to be able to expect to buy into it at short notice. And that isn't the case with our other channels. We usually close down 3 days in advance. So we're sort of gearing up quite heavily to put more resource into our traffic department and our copy-chasing department so that newspapers, for example, that might want to come on air on a Thursday or a Friday night and be active Friday and Saturday can make that booking on the day and have it broadcast that night. And I think what we've learned and what we've then conveyed to the agencies is that the reason it's happening now is because it's the first fully converged media brand across digital radio, digital television, ADSL, WAP phones, internet, etc. And that's really exciting for agencies. Agencies are crying out for the opportunity to be seen to be pioneering in innovative fields, and ITN is pioneering with a big brand in the most innovative fields around.
I think women are a lot more savvy now, and they were just...
The government sees its role here as stimulating debate. It says it has no intention of regulating the sorts of images that magazines and the fashion industry use.
From ITN, the ITV Lunchtime News.
Fashion magazine editors, advertising executives and top clothes designers had breakfast talks with the Health Minister, Tessa Jowell, about whether they contribute to the growing number of young people with eating disorders.
Well, in a moment, I'll be speaking to the editor of Cosmopolitan. But first, Helen Wright reports on what the so-called Body Image Summit hopes to achieve.
Today's summit began with a graphic illustration of just how teenagers feel about images of thin models. They left politicians and fashion editors in no doubt about the effect.
At that time, Superwife was coming in, supermodels. It was all the rage of slip dresses and, you know, young girls.
Hello Networks, IRN here. Next up we have new News Cut 38, Body Stroke Butler. Duration 10 seconds, outwards is success.
The pressure on women to be thin is stripping them of their self-esteem. That's the message from the government. Magazine editors, advertisers and designers have been called to a body summit in London to discuss the problem of women with eating disorders.
The Body Image Summit is not so much about looking good, but feeling good. Half of girls say their appearance is their biggest concern. The latest step there is...
So it's not clear what, if any, practical measures to address this issue will emerge from the summit. Helen Wright, ITN, Westminster.
What we're telling the outside world today is that we're offering ITN News as a ubiquitous service. You'll be able to get it on television, on digital radio, on PDAs, on laptops, any form of platform that the consumer has available to them. You'll be able to get ITN in audio, in video on demand, as a television service, as an interactive television service. We will be there for the consumer. Contrast that with the debate about news at 10. There you have a discussion about exactly where a programme is going to be scheduled on a particular network. Now you'll be able to get ITN News at 10 o'clock, in fact at any time you like, through any platform you like, through any media you like.
And there we go, there's nothing worse than having no lights there at all, is there? As a vision makes it.
Yeah.
Look.
No, if you go here to the second page, you have parallel access to 48 sources. You can pre-select, let's say here, another source.
This desk is in fact a digital desk, similar to Studio One, Studio Six. However, its automation capability is far better than either those two studios.
So is it all working?
How long is a piece of string? Yes, fundamentally it is. What we are doing, this process now, is a process of tuning, and we are tuning the gallery to allow us to use the production techniques that we want to use on News Channel.
I suppose I was thinking of a bracket, really, some sort of fixing that, it started with the idea of using a column, using a bit of the architecture. Obviously, we built our own column. But what I wanted to do was make something that looked as if it had actually sort of fitted round the architecture, was sort of permanent. It's a cantilevered structure, really, with the weight of this large perspex top taken by some quite chunky steelwork that runs into that column and then down through the column and back onto the floor. So it's actually quite a heavyweight piece of construction, even though hopefully in the end it looks as if it's floating.
There'll be kind of disasters in the pilots, clearly, and there'll be some, you know, hair pulling and wringing of hands in the pilots and people saying this isn't going to work, how are we ever going to get this on air? It'll work, I think. I think ITN will make it work.
How white are your knuckles?
Good question, Rob. I think there'll be some nervous days between now and launch, but we'll be there and I'm sure that it'll be a commercial success.
See the bubble, not the whooshes, isn't it?
Yeah, it is actually. That was the 5 second into headline, punctuated headline with the bed. We will edit that in Pro Tours in a moment.
At the moment I'm not entirely sure where they go, but I know this will all emerge as it goes along. If we just use those stings for any reason and wanted to mix into the studio or mix the newscaster, I'd probably use the softer one.
I see.
I think it's answered the brief very well. It combines both the future technology aspect of the News Channel, which is obviously being delivered across all the platforms, with the reliability, trustworthiness of the ITN channels as we know them. It's a 64-track recording with a full orchestra going on in there, all sections of the orchestra, I have to say. And although maybe that's not obvious, it's done the job of bringing those two elements together to make a fantastic piece of music.
Today we're announcing a family of constantly updated news services, which is providing the public, the consumer, with news
of the length they decide, whenever and wherever they want. No chat shows, no phone-ins, no magazine programmes. This is pure news and unashamed and proud to be news. The Summary is the world's first fully convergent digital news channel. It is all news, and I say unashamedly all news, and it is news you can trust with a brand you can trust.
I think marketing works best when everything points to the same position. So it's no good saying in promotion one thing and having the product say another. So it's very important that we have consistency. It's very important in the way that we deliver news, we're able to meet the proposition of how we're marketing the news. We have to work together to deliver a very fresh, new form of news delivery that the market hasn't seen at the moment.
Now we're coming direct to you.
Good.
Actually, we are shooting promotional trailers in different lengths, like 60 seconds, 30 seconds, 10 seconds. We also do that with promotion on the personal organizer or on the web phone. So that's kind of what we're doing now. And what we're doing actually now is shooting all the presenters who will be on the news channel. People, the viewers, the listeners, they're overflowed with information. You know, you go to work, and I think I read something, on the way to work, you were confronted with about 600
wheel, never ending or beginning, on an ever spinning wheel.
Bill, like how does the wheel come into the new channel operation?
Well, the wheel is the philosophy of breaking the hour down into 15-minute chunks. And as you've heard, the idea is that in each 15-minute chunk, we'll treat stories differently and we'll put different emphases on different subject areas. So, for example, in the first quarter hour, you would have the traditional package on the top story, followed by some other packages, some underlays to keep the pace going. And then you would have a business slot. The sport in that quarter hour would be headlines, but nothing more than that, and with a throw forward to say, stay with us for 10 minutes for the next full sports bulletin. Then there'd be a short weather. The second quarter hour, this time you might take the same top story, but do it with an underlay and a two-way with a correspondent on site somewhere. So basically, you're still getting the top stories of the day, but you're getting a different treatment in each quarter hour. And then this quarter hour, it might be the it would be, in fact, the sport, which would be given the long treatment, and the business would be nothing more than a run through the business headlines. And again, we'd say it would throw forward. Next main business bulletin in 10 minutes' time. Stay with us. In that quarter hour, just before the half hour, there'll be a long two-minute weather. Third quarter hour, this time perhaps on the top story, it'd be a background VT. Then we'd vary the stories beneath that. Emphasis would be back on business for that particular quarter and a short weather. And then the fourth quarter, well, this time we might play down the story that's been the top story on the hour and just give it underlay treatment, and that would allow us to deal in more depth with two or three other stories. This time the emphasis is on the sport, and this time there's a long weather. So you can see the idea is to take the main stories, treat them in different ways, and try and hold the viewer by varying the treatment, by including different middle grade stories, and by changing the emphasis between business, sport and weather.
I would hope that that the ITN News Channel does not just have the best of ITV and quite a lot of Channel 4, but also has some very good work from Channel 5. Our reporters have already helped out quite a lot in the core news relationship and delivered quite a lot into radio as well as the News Channel pilots already. So I'd hope to see a lot of our material being plucked off our programmes and run on the News Channel to give a sense of what ITN has to offer right across the range.
It's had an absolutely enormous impact. For a start, we've had to take on more people. We've now got four reporters, we've got more PJs, all packaging not just for the news channel, but for all our other customers, if I can call them that. And they're obviously much busier as a result. Hal Jones has been in Northern Ireland for the past few days. He's done nine lives for Channel 3 and Channel 5, five packages for 3 and 5, 10 radio reports, and 19 two-ways for the news channel. Annabelle Roberts, who's just joined us as a core reporter, she's come from Wimbledon, where she did 52 ways for the news channel over 2 weeks. So it's having an absolutely enormous impact.
For the next few months, what the ITV newsroom here will be concentrating on is trying to get that balance between making sure that we continue to provide distinctive, high-quality programmes for ITV, but at the same time fully supporting what is a very exciting prospect of a 24-hour news service.
That sounds like quite a tall order.
It is a tall order, but remember we've spent a long time planning for this. The great thing about the pilots is that we're now putting it to practice. I'm absolutely convinced that we're going to be able to make it work.
I think the biggest impact that News Channel is going to make on the life of Channel 4 News, in fact the life of everyone in the building, comes from the cultural step shift that will result from working for a company that is always on, that is always making news. The difference that will make in terms of early momentum to get the stories operationally, logistically, and early return of pictures, we can't even begin to consider now. It means that at Channel 4 News, for instance, we'll be able to make our decisions about how we develop stories and take them on, which is what our bread and butter is, rather than reporting them straight on, a lot earlier and a lot sooner. When you think about our contribution, though, to that effort, what that really means is a willingness and encouragement from me that my staff will participate, will do lives, will do two ways, which will give them a lot more experience, because that is a skill in itself, hard news lives, which means many more people can be exposed to that. And my production staff will be able to get exposed to and experience in attachments or whatever to the new forms of multi-scaling and production on a fast-moving news programme.
Now ITN delivers news on digital radio.
Digital radio is going to allow ITN to expand its brand over every conceivable platform. Obviously, there's a lot of attention to television, but digital radio is arguably the coming thing. We also feel that the rolling news format is really quite new tech and cutting edge. It may have been around for 35 or 40 years, but it's the closest equivalent to a website on air that I can think of. So I think it matches very well with everything that ITN is trying to do across a variety of platforms.
Just as ITN News Channel is launching, so is ITN Money Desk. We're based here in the ITN Radio Newsroom, but we're going to be a multimedia service. It's going to service ITN Online, it's going to service the News Channel, it's obviously going to service the ITN radio outlets, IRN and News Direct. This is unique, of course, to ITN, it's unique to any newsroom, and we'll actually have a team of 10 journalists here who will be literally multimedia journalists, working for the net, working for radio, and working for television.
There have been glitches with the server and the technology in general, the news control, there's no doubt about that. This is the first time that it's been used to this extent within ITN. The number of times I said to people, don't be disheartened at the end of days as a result of that. I hate to think about, but fingers crossed, the technology is now working pretty well. We will, as a matter of interest, be having a tape backup system in place. Obviously, we're not so stupid as not to be able to do anything about it if once we're launched, the whole thing crashes. But I'm pretty confident we can go on air with the new technology.
On August the 1st, you're going to turn on something that's never going to stop, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. How does that feel?
But news happens 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, so obviously ITN should be there. It's natural.
On August the 1st, You're going to turn on something that's never going to stop, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. How does that feel?
But news happens 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, so obviously ITN should be there. It's natural.
To start, we've had to take on more people. We've now got more PJs, more reporters.
Distinctive, high quality.
Over every conceivable platform.
It's on your television.
It's a transformation of us from a supplier to other broadcasters to becoming a broadcaster ourselves.
It's on your digital radio.
There have just been three explosions which have ripped, and there are gunmen and there are policemen on the balcony.
It's on the web and interactive TV.
This is unique, of course, to ITN. It's unique to any newsroom. Multimedia journalists working for the net, working for radio and working for television.
It's on your mobile phone.
Always on. It's always making news.
And it's on your personal organiser.
The top news stories, the top business stories, the top sport and the weather. If you watch for longer, you'll get the news in greater depth.
Some items, 60% cheaper.
Huge price war.
Day here, turn to night.
ITN delivers.
Non-stop news.
Wherever you are, whatever you're doing.
They've fired warning shots to make us go away.
He screams that one is falling.
On behalf of NTL and ITN, welcome to the launch of the ITN News Channel. I'm Stuart Purvis, the Chief Executive of ITN. Some of you who are old enough may remember back to the early days of British broadcasting to Alexandra Palace and an announcer probably in a dinner jacket saying, stand by cameras, stand by lights, stand by sound. Well, of course, in this world of convergence today, we're saying things like, stand by television channel, stand by website, stand by interactivity, stand by WAP phones, stand by video phones. That's how far things have changed. I would add standby radio channel, but in fact I said that at 5:59 this morning because radio always likes to get in first, and so we launched our national digital multiplex radio service this morning at 6 o'clock.
Today, ITN makes history. Today, ITN launches a digital radio channel for news. A TV channel for news. A website for news. From today, ITN is non-stop news.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
From today, ITN. Unmissable news. This is the ITN News Channel.
Good morning. It's 6 o'clock on Tuesday, the 1st of August. I'm Alex Ritson. Welcome to the ITN News Channel, a new service from ITN bringing you non-stop news wherever you are. Here are the headlines. Dump the pumps. Motorists are urged to join a nationwide petrol boycott. Day two of questioning for the Sarah Payne murder suspect. Coast Guards refused to give up hope of finding three students missing in the North Sea. In sport, Tottenham want Zenden to fill the gap left by the departing Ginola. Business news, all eyes are on the London tech stocks after big rises on the Nasdaq.
So that was the launch of the radio channel at 6 o'clock. Now we're moving on to the launch of the television channel and a whole series of other platform services to start at 1:30, which is just a few minutes away. The idea of an ITN news channel actually goes back 17 years to the then editor of ITN, David Nicholas, later Sir David Nicholas, who as editor asked me, a producer on News at 10, to put together a tape of what an ITN news channel might look like. There then followed a whole series of interesting meetings with personalities as colourful as Robert Maxwell and Ted Turner. Well, as you now know, our partners, in fact, for this venture are NTL, and what excellent partners they've turned out to be working together with us in so many ways. And I'm delighted that Lee Wood, the Chief Operating Officer of NTL, is here to speak on behalf of NTL and, of course, its Chief Executive, Bartley Knapp. Lee.
Thanks, Stuart. I was just trying to remember what I was doing 17 years ago. I think it probably had more to do with the cartoon channel than it did with any kind of world-class news. But I can tell you that NTL delighted that 16 and a half years later, that you waited to find the perfect partner, and in fact, it is NTL, and we are really happy to be here today. Joking aside, NTL absolutely recognizes the value of heritage and experience. And in the news business, the things that count, a reputation for accuracy, for integrity, for fairness, for timeliness, takes years, actually even decades, to establish. And ITN has done that, broadcast by broadcast, over the last 45 years. Without reputation, frankly, we wouldn't be here today. Together, we are building something that neither company could have built alone. And I think that really is the definition of a perfect partnership. So Stuart, thanks, back to you.
Thank you, Lee. Well, we're now 30 seconds away from launch, so some brief thank yous to all the staff of ITN, particularly the team working on the program led by the Editor-in-Chief, Richard Tate, to ITN's owners, Carlton, Granada United, Reuters and the Daily Mail, to our customers, particularly ITV, but also Channel 4, Channel 5, GMTV, CNN, NBC, and of course, IRN. They've all been tremendously cooperative and supportive. Julia Somerville is now in the studio just above us, and in any second she will launch the channel.
This is the ITN News Channel.
Dump the pump, drivers, petrol price verdict. Concorde crash, now French ground claims indefinitely. And born in a tree, baby Rosita's new plea for help. Good afternoon and welcome to the ITN News Channel. The much-hyped Dump the Pump campaign against high petrol prices looks set to flop. Many garages are reporting that business is virtually normal, but the campaign organisers are claiming success, and in some areas, especially in the north, drivers have been avoiding filling up.